Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the estimator theory. Today we will discuss about what is the sufficient estimator and how we can find the sufficient estimator for any of the distribution. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me, either of my email IDs are there if you feel any doubt regarding the probability statistics, else you can simply follow this link for more updated video. What is the brief content of this today's presentation is there. We will see what is the definition of the sufficient estimator, how we can find the sufficient estimator that is based on the factorization theorem which will provide you necessary and sufficient condition. Also, we will discuss about what is the Fisher-Neumann criteria, and the most important thing is that we will discuss about the two-step approach for finding the sufficient estimators. And finally, we will discuss about how we can find the sufficient estimator for this and many more are here. So let's start with this one. So any estimator, that is any of the estimator t, is said to be the sufficient for the parameter theta if it consists of all the information in the sample regarding of the parameter. What is the meaning of this? That we can define like this way also. If t is the estimator of the parameter theta based on the population of size n, such that the conditional distribution of the sample given that statistics is independent of the population parameter. So it means if you are able to find the distribution like this way, x1, x2 and then so on, condition of t, whatever the result you have obtained, it is independent of the population parameter, that is a theta, then we can say that statistics t is called as the sufficient estimator. How you can find them? That is based on the factorization theorem, which will help you to provide the necessary and the sufficient condition. What is that? If you can express any of the joint function L, what is a joint function is? This is nothing but my here with respect to the parameter. So if you are able to express this joint function L in terms of this, then where what is a G and what is the HR there, where G is the function which are depending upon the theta as well as the statistics t, and t is definitely the function of the x. So it means this g is a function of the theta as well as x also, while h of x is a function which are totally independent of the population parameter. Or you can say h of x is totally a function which are depending upon the x, like x of x size, product of x size and so on. So the important thing is, what is the meaning of the independent of parameter? So remember that the function which are independent of parameters does not mean that it does not involve the theta. For example, if I say f of x is 1 by 2a, clearly says that it does not involve the theta, but you have to also look about the domain. Like here, this is my function, this is my domain. So is this independent of theta? Yes, this is independent of theta. Is the domain also the independent of theta? No, because x is dependent upon the theta is there. So therefore, this function is depend on the theta. On the other hand, if I say my function is will be my 2 of a, x is here. Now clearly this is independent of theta, this domain is also independent of theta, then we can say f of x is independent of theta. Another condition is that the called as the Fisher-Neumann criteria. Again, we can start with the likelihood function or the joint function. Again, we can express if we are able to express in this form, but the only difference here is the property of the g. What is the g is? Now g is the probability density function or the mass function of the statistics. So if I say my function is like here, then you have to firstly find the PDF of this t. So it is not an always easy to task to find this the PDF of the sum of this xi's, where xi's have their own different PDFs are there. While h of x is same as that, it is dependent only on the x and independent of theta. Now since it is not an easy task for finding the PDF of this function, because this statistics t, it can be like of here divided by something are there, it can be of this, and so it is not an easy task for finding the PDF. So that's why we can say that this method requires the working of the PDF or the PMF, which is not an easy task. So we can't use the Fisher-Neumann criteria as a regular manner. But we will see how we can solve this Fisher-Neumann criteria in this video at the last of them. Now, how we can find the sufficient estimator for any of the problem? I will suggest you the two-step approach. What you can do is, we can start with the likelihood function L, and we can simplify this part. after the simplification, if we are able to express it's this in this form, then we can say this is the sufficient estimator provided this h of is independent of theta and g is the dependent on theta as well as x. Then we can say the function which are in this g which are dependent on the x, that is here, is called as the sufficient estimate. So we will see how we can solve them with the help of the 6-7 examples in this two-step approach. So look at the first example where the function is given to you. You have to find the sufficient estimator for theta. So you have to firstly check about the domain. So since the domain is here and this is independent of theta, so we can start with the likelihood function L. And what's our target is, our target is to express this in the form of here. So we can substitute the value of the f in this case, we can substitute here. So what is the product of theta? Since this is the constant value, so with respect to theta is nothing but here. And what is that? So I can express this rest of them as here. So can you write this as a function of this? So always try to look at the function of the hx. So in this expression, in this simplification, are you able to find a function which are totally dependent on the x? Still not, because still you want to simplify them. Since it is a negative minus 1, so you can express them here. So now you can see this is a function which are totally dependent on the x. So we can call this as the h of x. While what is the g of this? The function which are dependent upon the theta as well as the function of the x. You can see this is the function which are theta as well as of the x. So this is my g of t and this. So it means this function is in the form of here, where hx is this and g of this. So once you are able to write this, so therefore by the factorization theorem, look at that this g, what is the part of the x? So this is the part of the x. So we can say this is the sufficient estimator of the parameter here. Look at the another example on the same track. So look at this is the exponential distribution. Find the sufficient estimator for the exponential distribution. So again, we can start with the likelihood function and our target is to find this function here. So we can substitute the value of this in here. Again, you can see the domain, that is a 0 to x is less than infinity, is independent of theta. So we can this, we can express here as this is the constant, it can be written n part. So this is the product of here. So you know that how you can write the product of this? This is nothing but my summation r. Now can you write this function here? So firstly look at the h of x. Is in this expression, is any of the function which are totally dependent on the x? No, because this part is also dependent on the x. So we can say, I can write is 1 into. So it means this is the function of the x. And this is the function which are dependent on the theta as well as x. So it means this part is my g of this. And what is the h is? My 1. So which is the form of this? Provided h is my 1. And in this part, this is my g of this. So what is the value of t? This is the function which are dependent on the x. So this is the part which are dependent on the x. So t is my sum of xi. So we can say by factorization theorem, this is the sufficient estimate. Look at another example. Look at for the Cauchy distribution. Are you able to find the sufficient estimator or not? We can start with the likelihood function and the target is to check whether it can be written in this form or not. We can substitute the value here, we can express them here. Now, can you simplify more? Since this is the product, this is the expression of the xi, but you can't express this in terms of the summation. So it means which is not in the form of here. Because what is that this small t is? This is a function of either product of xi or sum of the xi or the combination of them. But here, this is not of the, can you find the function t which are totally dependent on the x in this case? No, it means which is not be possible. Therefore, there is no such single statistics which are sufficient estimator of here. Look at the another example. So this is the, you have to find the sufficient estimator for the mean and the variance from the normal distribution. So all of you know that what is the normal distribution is, what is the PDF of the normal distribution? This is the my PDF of the normal distribution, and your target is to find the sufficient estimator for mu and sigma square. So in this example, what is your theta is? For the first case, this is my first case when theta is mu, second case when theta will be my sigma square. So again, we will start with the likelihood function and our target is to reach at the same goal. So we can substitute the value of the PDF of the normal distribution and simplify them. Now again, now look at that. Now this is the summation side and this is the whole square. So we can open this summation and square we can express as here. So are you able to find a function which are dependent on this form? Are you able to find a function which are totally dependent on the x? So if you think about this is a function which are totally dependent on x, it is not, because 1 by 2 sigma square when you multiply them is a function of the parameter also. It means there is nothing of the function which are totally dependent on the x. So I can consider h of x is my 1 and this complete is my g of this. So look at that, how many functions are there which are dependent on the t? One is this and second is x square. So you can see there are the two statistics are there. One is with respect to the summation of the x by here and second is with respect to the x square. Now you can see this sum of the x is corresponding to the my mu. So we can say this summation of x is the sufficient estimator for the mean and sigma x square is the sufficient estimator for the, this is for the sigma square with h of x is 1. Look at the another example where you can find the sufficient estimator for the Bernoulli distribution, and all of you know that what is the probability mass function of this. So in this case you can see what is the theta is population parameter, that is in this case is p. So my target is to express the function in this form. Now here this is the discrete distribution. So how you define this L? So now you are unable to express in the form of the product. So instead of them we can define the joint density function in the form of discrete here. Also they are independent. So all of you know that how you can find the probability of A, B in case of the independent. This is probability of A into probability of B. So this is my A, this is B, this is C and so on. So our target is to write here. So now this theta is nothing but my P. Since they are my independent, so I can express in this form. I can substitute the value of this into this expression and after the simplify you can see this P and this P, you can combine them here. Or you can also simplify them. This is nothing but my summation of x. So can you say this is a function of this? Are you able to find a function which are totally dependent on the x? Not. So it means I can written as a 1. Are you able to find a function which are dependent on the x as well as the parameter p? So you can see this is itself a function which are dependent on the p as well as on the x. So it means this is nothing but my here. So therefore which is in the form of this provided h is my 1. So what is the capital T is the function which are dependent on the xi. So this is the only function. So therefore by factorization theorem we can say this is the sufficient estimator for the p. Similarly, look at the next example. You can see how you can find the sufficient estimator for the Poisson distribution. So you know this is the Poisson distribution PMF. And in this case, what is the theta is lambda. Again, they are independent. So you can, and this is my discrete distribution. So you can define the joint density function like this way. Now your target is to check whether this is in the form of here or not. So since they are independent, it is given to you. They are independent. So you can write them here. We can substitute the value this for the each of the case. We can write like this way. So you can combine them. This is e raised to power. This how many times? This is n number of times are here. So can you say this is then the form of this? So are you able to find a function which are totally dependent on the h of which are totally dependent on the xi's? Yes, you can see that. This is a function. You can see 1 upon this is a function which are totally dependent on the x. So therefore we can say my h of x is this and the remaining thing that is here is my g of this. So what is, therefore it is written this form. So what is the sufficient estimator? Look at in this expression, what is the value of the xi? So this is the value of the xi. So this is nothing but my x, sum of the xi is the sufficient estimator for the mean. Look at the last example which is related to the gamma distribution and which is of the two parameter gamma distribution. So you can see the gamma distribution video in the description part. Else you know what is the PDF of the gamma distribution and you know this is my continuous distribution. So you can define the likelihood function as of this. So once you have substituted the value of f of xi in this case, you can calculate the values as here. Now again, since this is a minus of 1, you can express this as you can express here. You can write them instead of this, you can write them here. Now, are you able to find a function which are totally dependent on the x or h? You can say either you can write h of x is 1 or you can write h is my here. If you write this minus 1 as a part of this. What is the g of t and what is the theta is? Now, parameters are alpha and beta. So, you have to think about this. This is a parameter of the alpha and beta. This is the parameter of the alpha. This is here. So, now this g is my, this part is there. In this case, you can see there are the two functions. One is called as the t1 for the product. Second is the sum of them. So therefore, there are the two sufficient estimator. One is corresponding to the alpha and second is beta. Look at that. This sum of the xi is corresponding to the beta. So we can see this sum is corresponding to the beta. This product is related to the alpha. So we can see the product is related to the alpha sufficient estimator of the gamma distribution. So this is a simple procedure. You can try to solve any of the problem with the help of this two-step approach. So what are the conclusion is that the sufficient estimator will never be the unique. Why? Because if you find the sufficient estimator and if there any exists g which is a one-to-one function, then g of this is also be the sufficient estimate. It means it will never be unique. Also, the sufficient estimator need not be the unbiased, but it is always be the consistent. So this is very useful for your computation examination. Also, if you find the unique MLE, so that is called as the UMVE, that we will already discuss that. So then it must be the function of the sufficient estimate. So if you want to look at this lecture again, so all those estimator where the UMV exists is also be the sufficient estimate. So that's all about this sufficient estimator lectures are there. I hope you can enjoy it too. We will see more examples related to the Fisher-Newman criteria and how we can find this for the sufficient estimator in our next class. Till then, simply follow this link for finding the more updated video. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.